A leader is someone who has influence over people. And because you're in that position of influencing a group of people, there comes more responsibilities, more expectations, and more criteria and requirements to carry yourself at a higher level so that whoever is watching you, just by watching how you live, they become inspired to become better, to become a bigger version of themselves. I feel like a lot of these qualities just make good common sense to have. Hi guys, this is Linda from Brain Education TV. If this is your first time, welcome! Please like this video, consider subscribing to our channel, and click the bell for notifications of each new episode. In this video, I'm going to talk about the five qualities of a leader based on brain education teachings. Are you somebody who aspires to become a leader? Are you somebody who wants to create some kind of positive change and be a driving force in creating good in the world? If you're somebody who aspires to be a leader, especially if you're a young person right now and you're imagining the years to come in your life to be something of great influence, of great power, of great success, then these five qualities of what it takes to become a leader will be very, very important to you. There are many leaders in the world today, people who are in positions of power, positions of fame, positions of status, and yet not all of them display qualities that are admirable to have in a leader. I think people get caught up in the superficial things about what it means to be a leader, of the power that you have, the fame, the status, the recognition that you're above a group of people. I think people get caught up in that and get attracted to that aspect of becoming a leader, but actually becoming a true leader is something that is beyond the surface. To become a true leader, you have to have certain qualities inside that make you someone who is righteous, someone who is just, someone who truly has the qualifications to stand at the forefront of humanity, to truly lead people towards the right direction, towards the right future. So in brain education, Ilchi Lee teaches that a leader first and foremost needs to have good, upright, righteous human character. Human character is defined by values, beliefs, lifestyle, and a perception and outlook that serves humanity, that makes me live a life that is truly human. So then let's get down to the five qualities as taught by brain education that make a truly great leader. So these five qualities, they build on each other. So number one is most important, and then it goes down the list, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the first quality, number one quality that's most important in a leader is integrity. Integrity is the quality that makes someone do the right thing, even though there's no one watching, even though there's nothing to gain from you doing the right thing. When a lot of eyes are on you, it's pretty easy to do the right thing because you're afraid of the repercussions of not doing the right thing when people are watching. The judgment, the criticism, the rejection, all of this can help fuel someone to do the right thing when a lot of people are watching. However, a true test of character of someone's beliefs and virtues is, can that person act with integrity? In other words, can that person do the right thing even though there's no reward at the end? Even though there's nobody watching, nobody that's giving you praise, nobody giving you recognition, nobody telling you you're a good person, even though there's nobody watching and you have nothing to win or lose by doing the right thing or the wrong thing, can you still, in that moment, stand by your beliefs and do the right thing? That is integrity. Integrity is number one because if you have integrity, then even if you have power, even if you have money, even if you have status, you will not become corrupt. Because at the foundation of integrity is me living truthfully, me living honestly. So if you can hold on to integrity as a leader, you will be less tempted to become corrupt. And in our modern day and age, how valuable is an uncorrupt leader? There are many examples of corrupt leaders in the world. So people who are uncorrupted in their position of leadership are very valuable and necessary to our society now. Number two, diligence. Diligence is number two because, okay, after integrity, you're a leader of righteousness, you know what to do. But if you don't have diligence, you fall into laziness. When a leader is not diligent and falls into laziness, then no change can occur. So something that Ilchi Lee teaches a lot is no action, no creation. If someone is diligent and they take action to create positive change, then that leader will be very effective in their role. However, if they aren't diligent and they fall into laziness, they get too comfortable, oh yeah, I'm in a position of power, oh yeah, if everybody do these things for me, I could just lounge back and just enjoy my life, that kind of leader will fall into laziness, and laziness causes no change in your world and in other people's. So, needless to say, when you're in a position of power, it's very important to work hard, be diligent, to actively create the change that you want to see in the world. Number three, responsibility. Responsibility is number three because having a sense of responsibility gives you a sense of purpose and mission in your leadership so that all of your energy and efforts can be focused on creating a common good. Something that's beyond myself, something that goes beyond the limits of my capability, beyond the limits of my awareness and consciousness. Having responsibility will pull that leader to the next level to act, think, behave beyond their comfort zone. So this sense of responsibility is what distinguishes a good leader from a great leader. The minute you take responsibility, you are carrying the lives of other people on your back, saying that, with this one life, I will use all of my energy to bring good for people beyond just myself, beyond just my immediate family. It's natural instinct for somebody to take care of themselves, take care of their family. You don't have to be someone great to know that much. Even the most corrupt politicians, corrupt leaders take care of themselves and take care of their family. But that is where it stops, and that's what differentiates just a good leader between them and a great leader, because once you take responsibility, you see the world with bigger eyes and you see the scope of your role with more people in mind. So someone who acts beyond just the good of themselves and good of their family and now to their community and then even bigger, humanity at large, that person with that sense of global responsibility will act, behave, and think in a much bigger way and will feel more purpose, more mission in what they do. And as a result, more joy, more satisfaction too. Number four, courtesy. Even if you're someone who's honest, works hard, and has a sense of responsibility, if you're a freaking asshole, then you can never be an effective leader. If you don't know how to embrace love and take care of the people on your team and take care of the people that you're responsible for, and all you do is walk around with arrogance, oh, look at me, I'm a leader, I have all this power, all this money, all this status, then you will never gain the respect of the people who are your constituents. A teaching and brain education that Ilchi Lee likes to repeat all the time is the way you receive love from somebody. If you're somebody who wants to be loved by people, be someone who is very courteous. When you have good manners and you're a very courteous person, people will naturally love you. So a leader, because you are in a position of influence, because there are people who look up to you as a role model, more so than other people, you must become a model of courtesy, a model of good behavior and good manners, because there are people who are literally looking up to you to learn subconsciously how you act, how you behave, how you talk, and will mirror whatever you do. So like social media influencers, celebrities, politicians, even teachers, parents, anyone in a leadership role where you have a following, it's very important to be courteous so you, through your life, through your actions, you indirectly teach those who are watching you to mirror your behavior. So this is just my personal thought, but more so than anything, we nowadays have less emphasis on this area of courtesy. I feel like we're a little bit more rude to each other than we used to be back in the day. So let's bring back courtesy. Let's make having good manners cool again so that we can create a new generation of people who are very well behaved, have very good manners, and are loving and empathetic towards each other. Number five, credit. Credit means being able to be trusted by other people. Are you trustable? Are you reliable? Can people depend on you? When you are in a leadership role, it's very important that you become someone who is trustable and dependable. because that is the foundation of growing your audience, growing your following, growing your constituents, growing the people who listen to you and who take your advice. So how do I become a more trustable person? Become somebody who actually does what they say. Instead of throwing your words around lightly and saying things that are socially acceptable, but you don't really mean it, and it's just whatever I'm just saying because I just don't know what else to do. I don't know what else to say. So I'm just saying things to fill the time. Or I'm saying things because I don't want to make them feel bad, but I don't really mean what I say. Become somebody whose word is something that people can trust. Because whatever comes out of your mouth, whatever you say, even though it might seem like such a light thing, it's actually a promise that you make with the person who is listening to you, and also a promise that you make with yourself. So if you say you're gonna do something by a certain time, actually do something by a certain time so that people can, through your actions, see, ah, this person is trustable, this person is reliable, I can count on them. How do you think you can be a great leader if what you say, you don't do? So you say, oh yeah, I'll finish that by a certain time, but you never carry out your promises. How can people ever trust you? And if people don't trust you, how can you lead a group of people? That is why number 5 is credit. Be somebody who doesn't just throw their words around lightly, doesn't make empty promises. Somebody who, if they say that they're gonna do something, they actually carry out that deed to the end. And actually, the reason why credit is number 5 is because if you have all of the previous 4 qualities of being a leader, you will naturally gain credit by society and gain credit by those around you. If you have integrity, if you have diligence, if you have responsibility, and if you have courtesy, then naturally number 5 will come. You will have credit with people. So these are the 5 qualities of a leader that is taught by Brain Education Methods and taught by our founder, Ilchi Lee. What'd you guys think? I feel like a lot of these qualities just make good common sense to have. And the thing that I really want to emphasize again is that a leader is someone who has influence over people. And because you're in that position of influencing a group of people, there comes more responsibilities, more expectations, and more criteria and requirements to carry yourself at a higher level so that whoever is watching you, just by watching how you live, they become inspired to become better, to become a bigger version of themselves. So let me know what you guys thought about this topic. Do you resonate with any of these qualities? Maybe one of them really stuck out to you, or one of them is something that you can see that you need to work on. Whatever it may be, I want to hear your thoughts. So let me know in the comments below what you guys thought about the 5 qualities of a great leader. Thank you all so much for tuning in. I'll see you in another video very soon. Bye!